One of these shots was taken by a $1,000 professional grade drone. The other was taken on a cheap $50 drone from Amazon. In this video, we're going to put these two drones to the test to see if you can do professional grade work on a cheap drone. We're going to compare these drones in three categories: the software, the overall flight capabilities, and the hardware on the drone. Ultimately, I want to answer the question, can you create professional grade video on a cheap drone? First, let's start with the software. When we open up the DJI Fly app and we connect our controller and everything, we open up to a nice menu screen asking to go fly. Within a few seconds, you're able to soar the skies. There are different menus and a lot of pop-ups coming up on screen, but once you break everything down and you understand what each area of the software does, it's pretty easy to understand and navigate. And this is the cheap drone software. Where the DJI Fly app is complicated, this software is very, very minimalistic. So minimalistic, in fact, that I really struggled to even get the drone on and started and up in the air. I don't know if this would be considered hardware or software, but it actually took longer to get the drone up and flying than the drone actually flew around for. It says it has a one-push takeoff, but whenever I pushed the button, it never took off. Overall, the cheap drone software was not very good. But that doesn't mean that we can't use it for professional use. Let's take a look at the overall flight capabilities of both of these drones. Let's start with the Mini 3 Pro. What I love about this drone is you get exactly what's advertised. You get a quality, sturdy drone that can fight wind over 20 miles an hour. All the advertised flight capabilities simply just work with the push of a button. The drone is super responsive to the controller, and I never really have to worry about the drone randomly falling out of the sky or doing anything that I don't want it to do. Unlike the cheap drone, which literally fell out of the sky. There was no warning when the battery died, and it just kinda fell down into the ground. That being said, I was surprised to see that the 360 degree turn actually worked. The batteries were advertised at 15 minutes each, and they actually lasted that long. But my absolute favorite part about this cheap drone is the fact that it's subscribed to my YouTube channel down below. The biggest issue with the flight of the cheap drone was the wind resistance. There was just a slight breeze, but it took the drone away. Oh, whoa. I know with some of the sketchy conditions that I've flown the Mini 3 Pro in, I'm not sure if the cheap drone would be able to make it. Even though the drone was a little shaky, the footage is going to shock you. And that brings us to our biggest differentiator between these drones, the hardware. Let's visit that first example again. The cheap drone, drumroll please, was actually neither of these videos. Even though this drone is advertised as a 4K drone, all the footage is crappy 1080p. This footage is practically unusable. That, paired with the wind resistance and everything else, I think it's safe to say that you cannot use a cheap drone for professional work. This drone would probably get you sued because you're going to hit somebody. All that being said, is the cheap drone even worth buying for your kids? Unless they're going to play with it once then toss it in the closet for the next 14 years, I don't even think it's worth it for you to get this for your kids. You'd be much better off getting a DJI Mini 2 SE, a Mini 4K, or something along those lines that's still affordable, yet you can get a good quality footage. If you've enjoyed this video, you might like to check out my previous video where I break down the exact cost of starting a drone business.